Thing that I made, I just recently I've been. Yeah, so recently I bought this USB soldering iron online. You know, sometimes you want to go for portable soldering, right? Then there's like two options. Either you get one from Hakko that's like AA battery powered, or there's another that's butane. So the butane one is a bit, I don't feel safe using it, so I didn't consider. Then the Hakko one is a bit pricey, so I decided to go to Taobao and see, you know, maybe there's something interesting. So there's this, let me just take it out and show you. So anybody wants to make a guess like how much is this? So it looks like this.
Everything is $1.
Yeah, so how much?
$8.
Yeah, so I think nowadays the price went down, now it's $6, plus your shipping and everything. Yeah, so like any other hardware guy, right? So when I get this soldering iron, right, what's the first thing that you do?
Dismantle.
Yeah, I'll dismantle. So haven't even power on to check whether it works, right? Then I dismantle, then I open this thing, then guess what happened? So they say, oh, you know you can change the tip. So I take out, then guess what happened? The heating element came out. Then I was like, oh shit. Then what am I gonna do? I said, okay, never mind. Since this thing is like $6, right? Maybe find a replacement tip. Probably maybe $1.50. Oh, then the tip is $3. And I'm like, okay. So guess how I fix it. So you know the thing is like dangling, right? No other option already. So what I did, just like twist. Then hope that it doesn't touch the outer casing. Then put it back. So actually I don't know if it will still power on now. I mean, as of last night, it's still working, so let's try it. Yeah. But for $4, it's quite a nice tool to have. So let me just power up. I mean, I don't understand why the tip is more expensive than the whole thing, or rather, almost half the price, but yeah. So I haven't measured the power consumption and everything, but this comes with like an audio jack kind of cable. It goes to USB, so you just plug in on the back. So there's this metal ball over here. Yeah, so if you press, then there should be a blue light. Yeah, so it works. Yeah. So one thing I did, I try, because sometimes I do some small little casing, right? So I actually use it to, can't see. Hold on. So you see, you can see the brass insert there, right? So usually what you do is actually you use a soldering iron, you put the brass insert somewhere here. Yeah, then you actually push it through your 3D printed part. Then you actually have a casing that you can screw stuff on. Yeah. So I actually tried with this. So I just turn on, then I just like put it, and it managed to work. So I think the heat is pretty okay on this small little thing. Yeah. Then, okay, so I've not tried soldering before, so I'm gonna try it now. So I have a little board over here. Let's try it. Since it's hardware, right? And actually I have no idea what's the temperature. Yeah, it's $4. Alright. For the very first time, let's try. Pray to the demo gods now. Yeah, so you know, I told you that I actually sort of like damaged it, right? Because I took out then the filament, or rather the heating element wire came out, right? Then there's sometimes when I put the insert, then I used too much force, then the thing tripped. Yeah. So eventually I took it out, then I twist a bit more, then I put back. Yeah, so it's still kind of alive now. So it's not. Oh, it's dead. Okay, good. All right, so now it's turned on. Let's hope that it works. So I also have no idea what's the power consumption. Yeah. But yeah, probably at some point I'll measure. So it's heating up. Let's just try. Doesn't look like. Oops, sorry. He's kind of awkward. Oh, it works. Okay, let's try to solder one leg. Hope that it works. So I have this board here with a lot of legs not soldered yet. Let me just adjust. Right. Oh, okay. Hold it can. There we can. Okay. Let's try one of these.
Okay.
Oh, it works. Seems like the heat doesn't dissipate so well, so get like a half solder joint. Okay, I give up. Alright, so yeah. If you think you have a lot of time and yeah, you wanna suffer with a half baked solder, yeah, buy one. Yeah. But I think it's very useful for making like inserts or doing some field work. Maybe you go to the field, you know. You have one wire that came out and you cannot fix. Yeah, this might be useful. If not, then spend money and buy a Hakko. Probably serve you better. Okay, yeah, so that's all. If you want to try later after the talk, you can.
Actually, somewhere on tech today, right?
Yeah.
Someone came up with a schematic for you to upgrade this.
Oh, seriously?
Yeah.
Oh, there I should look at it. So, but for $6 upgrading,
okay. I mean, compared to buy something that's ready at $50.
Right. Actually, I have no idea what they. How they even wire this thing, but yeah.
Someone actually came up with a schematic to upgrade this.
So it says here 5 volt, 8 watts. Yeah. Pretty powerful, right? 1.8 amps, yeah. 1.6 amps, yeah. Alright, so that's all. So just a little toy that I bought just to keep the interest going. Yeah. So if any little toy that you have, yeah, bring to Hackware next time.